gave you the number earlier if you're just joining us. Clippers coming off a four-day break. This year, teams that have had a four-day break are 1-8. Clippers had one of those losses back in November. George for three. It's good. 114-106, 5:15 to play. We saw him take over the final 5 minutes against the Thunder. Wouldn't mind seeing him do that here today against Brooklyn.
You got the bonus situation working. The three-possession game with the three ball in effect if you can get stops.
Great pass by Dinwiddie inside. Foul on the floor. It is the third against the Clippers. Foul for Westbrook. To shoot, deflection, knocked out of bounds by Harden. 1.7 to shoot now for Brooklyn.
Cross court.
Clippers elect not to guard the inbound. Now George comes over to do it. Lob at the rim. No. Harden with a running chase down. Ahead to Leonard, to the rack with two, and he hangs on the iron, and he brings the Clippers to within six. 4:35 to play.
And give Paul George the credit. Because he sprinted up the court, he cleared out the lane for Kawhi to fill right in behind him. An excellent delivery by James Harden.
Claxton for three. He's hit one this year. They'll pay him to shoot it from out there.
Man, that was a bad shot by Claxton. Now it gives us an opportunity.
Yep. And now Kawhi Leonard will go to the line after a collision inside against Johnson.
So think when you're not open, I mean, he puts it on the deck and attacks and gets to the line.
Free throws 30 and 31 for the Clippers. Going to see in the playoffs, shots not falling, other team is hot, and they respond. They are responding, but so too have the Brooklyn Nets, as we've talked about. Every run the Clippers have made, Brooklyn has answered in kind. 4 minutes to play.
Yeah, but Brooklyn also, too, has been known in late-game situations not to be able to close the deal. So you want to put the pressure back on Brooklyn and have to make the right plays. Just travel.
Johnson with five to shoot. Attacks on Harden. Tough shot. Rebound Westbrook. Here come the Clippers with numbers. Westbrook in the corner for Powell. The three. Yes, sir! 1 point game!
Create a run, which they have right now. Like I said, one possession game.
There's been different closing lineups for Brooklyn throughout the season. One constant is Mikal Bridges. Third most points in the clutch, which is where we are right now in the NBA. Dinwiddie picked up by Powell. In jail. Gives to Claxton, five to shoot. Claxton goes to work. And a late foul there that probably had to be applied by Westbrook because Claxton was going straight to the rim. I'm very good at quiet quitting.
Quiet quitting. I'm going to use that one.
3:22 to play. Big possession here on both sides of the ball. Johnson drives on Harden. Rolls off the iron. The Clippers have it. Westbrook battling for the loose ball. Oh, it's an effort play. It's an effort play by Westbrook. You tip your cap to him. It'll stay with Brooklyn.
I mean, right there, just inches away from getting this. And Claxton, Russ, grab it. I can't get it. It hits Claxton. And then right there.
Yep.
All right, another stop.
He out-rebounded Claxton. He just couldn't hold on to it.
Nope, another stop.
And the Clippers continue to show their teeth. Not letting Thomas, they're doing everything they can to not get him the ball. He does get it. A whistle, a travel, a turnover.
And you know why that happened? Paul George, on consecutive times when he had to get over the top of the screen, he didn't get bumped. He didn't allow himself to lay on the screen and take the easy way out. That forced a turnover.
Clippers are down one. Leonard for the lead. He put it in! 115-114 Clippers! Bridges trying to turn the corner. Thomas alone for the three. Rebound poked around. Harden has it. Leads it to Leonard. Wrapped up. A whistle and a foul. Two free throws coming for Kawhi Leonard.
But when you needed it, he needed it. His team needed it. He got it up and over. And now, at at the free throw line.
It was 104-86 Nets. It's now 117-114 Clippers. Brooklyn has bounced back all afternoon, but they're up against the ropes right now. 10 to shoot for Dinwiddie. It's a deep three. Big rebound by George.
Again, the little things. Kawhi got over the top of the screen. That didn't allow kind of an easier look.
Leonard on Johnson. George for three. And Johnson steps out of bounds.
And that was Russ fighting in between Nick Claxton. He didn't get it, but the extra effort. Watch Russ come into the play right here. He's able to tap it just a little bit. And if he's not there, Cam Johnson is able to really have a clear path to get that defensive rebound.
Last week in Minnesota, the Clippers went small and got back into the game. They're doing the same thing here in the fourth quarter. There have been minutes, there have been games where Russ and Harden have shared the floor and it's been a disaster. But perhaps they have found something here over their past week or so. Leonard needs to call a timeout, but he steps out of bounds. Big turnover for the Clippers.
Yeah, it was some contact by Dorian Finney-Smith. Kawhi was a little straight up and down, a little nonchalant that time with that possession, and it paid off for Brooklyn, but still have a three-point lead, one possession, another chance to get another stop.
Bridges. Thomas, a good look at a three for the tie. Leonard with the rebound, 1:25 to play. Whistles on either side are free throws. Plenty of time to shoot. Kawhi for three. Hot damn! 120, 114, a minute to play. Westbrook. Finish for the Clippers. And Harden wisely pulls it up. 122 to 114. The Clippers trailed by 18 in the fourth quarter. Kawhi for three. Oh my goodness! 15 in the fourth quarter. The Clippers dominating on a 22-0 run.
Only scored 47 points in the game, in the paint, 26th in the league, and they already have 16 tonight.
How about that pass from Giannis, and Bobby Portis cashes it in, went over the head on a bounce pass, did Giannis Antetokounmpo. Tatum and Holiday with KP, Brissett and Hauser on the floor. O'Shea Brissett played just 5 minutes last night, but figured to be a factor and already is. Holiday misses. Here's Lillard now. Giannis pushes with the pink shoes. Giannis, a freight train. No, got his own, and the putback. 9 for Giannis in the first.
The Bucks are wearing Boston out in transition. Not normally a great running team this year, but they have been great in transition tonight.
Brissett left open. Jackson tips it to himself. Lillard. Good D by Brissett. Lillard got the dribble back. Under a minute to go here. Lillard off to a fast start. Miss Monday. Same corner, loose sidestep, blow by Bobby Portis. Another three, and the Bucks have 39 on the board in this first quarter. They've almost doubled up their first quarter production from Monday against Utah. Giannis guarding Tatum. Matchup of heavyweights. Oh, Portis with a steal. Hauser, the man to beat. Portis drops the shoulder, lays it in. And it's a 40-piece in the first for Milwaukee.
Couldn't have gone much better this first quarter for the Bucks.
Shot clock is off. Tatum just 4 points, 1 of 3, just 3 attempts. Brown 2 of 7, he scored just 4. And now Tatum, a 3-pointer, no. Portis keeps it alive. Is that going to take us to the end of the quarter? It is.
Then, you know, start making shots.
After a tough stretch of losing 5 of 8, what does a start like this just do for the confidence in general of your team?
Man, great, man. You know, the 82-game season is, you know, to get better, find your chemistry, camaraderie. So losing 5 out of 8, we weren't worried. The most biggest thing was just staying together through the tough times. You know, adversity always hits for every team at some point, and we just got to be strong through it all.
And our thanks to Bobby Portis. Bucks with the first possession of this second quarter. Just got it off late. Bobby Portis, coach, he 11 points, as you mentioned. He had a string of games where it was a struggle for him offensively. Single-digit scoring in 6 straight games. Just 8 points in 16 minutes Monday against Utah. So you know he is glad to put double figures on the board in the first as Holiday misses over Giannis. Connor to touch it last, Hauser, and that'll be Bucks ball. We saw Boston throw a little zone at the Bucks in that last possession.
And they're coming right back with it here. An interesting zone. They start with two guards up front. We see Hauser and Pritchard. Jrue Holiday plays at the free throw line. Joe Mazzulla said they don't have a lot of rules on their zone. They really rely on Jrue Holiday to just talk and match up with people coming up. They switch the pick and rolls.
And now Holiday ends up on Giannis. That's the counter. Giannis a turnaround jumper, and if he's going to make that, it's going to be a long night for the opposition.
I had a college coach I worked with once, Nick McCarchuk, and we had a guy doing things like that, and I said, he kept going, and we tried a few things, and I said, Coach, what are we going to do? And he said, we're going to lose. Now sit down, and that's about what you feel when Giannis is making shots like that. It's going to be a long night.
Giannis is 5 for 7. This is Middleton's turn now. Middleton misses. Jackson with a rebound. Kicks it out to Portis. Ooh, Bobby Portis is on a heater right now. Another 3-pointer for Bobby Portis. That's his third. He's got 14 in just 8 minutes. Sam Hauser cannot answer.
Well, the difference in the game right now is the 3-point shooting. 1 for 11 for the Celtics, who rely on 3-point shooting. They're number one in the league in makes and attempts. And the Bucks 7 for 11 now.
Middleton misses. Tatum tips it out to Connaughton. Thought he had a teammate out there, and Giannis is fouled on his way in. Tatum's upset, slams the ball down. And 3 opportunities on this side of the floor for the Bucks, resulting in free throws.
Well, in today's game, so many rebounds are people running in from the corner to rebound the ball or long rebounds. The Bucks get 2 of them. And Giannis gets a chance to capitalize at the free throw line.
And when Giannis is at the line, we have plenty of time to remind you. I mean, plenty of time.
Yeah, well, it's actually ridiculous. We can get to that later. That they just changed the rules for this guy at the free throw line.
Anyway, NBA All-Star. Didn't want to get you all fired up there, Coach. But All-Star voting is presented by AT&T. It is underway. You can vote now to help send your favorite players to Indianapolis next month. See, I can take my time with this. Every vote, Stan, with your NBA ID, gives you a chance to win a trip to NBA All-Star 2024. Vote daily on the NBA app or at NBA.com.
You can read it again. If anybody missed it, we can read it again. And it really is, I just don't get it. I know he's a great player and everything, but it started, they'd give him the ball right on time, and it would take over 10 seconds to shoot it. So then now they just let him go through this whole routine without the ball, and then they give it to him. I mean, why doesn't everybody in the league do that? Joel Embiid should do it to get more rest.
Holiday misses the three. Portis with the rebound. I didn't mean to get you all fire started.
Oh my gosh.
It's a cold night. Giannis, nice catch in traffic. Just moves Cornette out of the way. And this run is now 18-0 Milwaukee. All 18 by Giannis and Bobby Portis at this point. And they've got a chance to extend it. Disastrous start for Boston. Looking every bit the team that won an overtime game last night. Portis hits another, and Joe Mazzulla, a desperation timeout. Portis is into it. The Celtics a little something here. These are the minutes played last night at home against the Timberwolves. Four players logging over 40 minutes. Al Horford will not play tonight. He was the one casualty and does not play in back-to-backs. Celtics have been excellent in second games of back-to-backs, but this is a rough start for the Seas, the team with the best record in the NBA. It keeps going. Chris Middleton buries a three, and the Milwaukee Bucks have 54 on the board. A drought of over 5 minutes, almost 6 minutes, and going over 6 minutes for Boston. Wow.
Well, and I think more importantly from the Bucks, their offense has been great, but we've seen that a lot. More importantly for the Bucks, they have held Boston to 27% from the floor and 1-for-13 from three and only put them at the line four times. So very important for the Bucks to start playing a little bit better defense. And at least tonight, they have made this Boston team take difficult shots.
Let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Well, one thing Coach told us really bothered him about the defensive stretch so far this season that they've been on is just the attention to detail on the scouting report hasn't been there. And then the respect for the three-point line. Those are two things that are so controllable. And that's what you like to see as a coach. You can't fix laziness. You can't fix a lack of skill.
They have dropped the first two meetings. They have another game coming up. Third week of February as Jokic working on Looney. Little hook shot is good. Jokic adding to his total now. He's got 27. Yeah, look at that. 60 second half points already. We got 6:20 left in this fourth quarter.
They haven't been able to take anything away tonight. 15 made threes, but 54 points in the paint. The Warriors are last in the league, averaging only 43 in the paint, 54 tonight.
Thompson always left open, and he missed it. Looney with the offensive board, got another one. Another chance here for Golden State. Shot clock to seven, Curry, no. And Michael Porter Jr. with a rebound. Curry started 2-for-7, just got cooking after that. Made 4 3-pointers, 9 for his last 12. Murray to Jokic inside in the paint. Gordon the offensive board. And Gordon.
Consistency.
Been to the line 5 times in this one as Gordon hits both free throws.
Boy. Jokic only averages shooting just short of 6 free throw attempts a game, so he doesn't get to the line a lot.
Curry almost lost the handle, keeps it going. Jokic trying to stay with him, and Curry missed it, and a loose ball foul. Golden State pushed their lead to 18 at 1 point. Nuggets' biggest lead tonight was 10 points. Here's Gordon in the corner, and here come the Nuggets. Corner three from Aaron Gordon. They've been daring him to shoot those threes. Gordon's got 22 now in his second game back after missing two. And Michael Malone is upset. Steve Kerr wants a timeout.
So it's tough as a referee when on the same call both coaches are upset with you.
Yeah, pretty sure Jokic is not going to stop because Steve Kerr is requesting it. Pajemski probing now with two on him, the two stars. Now Wiggins, five to shoot, gives it back. Pajemski, the lefty. Oh, and Gordon just denies him. Shot clock violation.
Late.
Denver's on a 7-0 run here in the last minute and a half. We're trailing by 18. Jokic kicks it. Three-pointer flies. Gordon short. Gordon with the putback. Impressive.
Well, Gordon's been very, very good tonight, but both offenses have been very good. Other than the three-point shooting, Denver's been very good offensively. It's been tough to come by stops tonight.
Gordon's got 9 in the quarter. 24 for the game. That's the 10th offensive rebound for Denver. Curry, bullet pass out to Wiggins. In and out it goes. Murray with the rebound. Nuggets trying to keep this run going here. 9-0 currently. Murray for three. Short. Long offensive board to Jokic. Gordon's got Curry posted up. And that is a foul on Curry. Free throws for Gordon. Sean Wright asking JT Orr who he had.
Finding him and he takes advantage down there. This is always a little bit of a problem. Gordon, not a great free throw shooter.
Well, Gordon tonight.
Steve Kerr wanting to get a little bit more size on Aaron Gordon, who's taking advantage of them around the basket. So he goes with two bigs now. Something that he doesn't do a lot, doesn't like to do, particularly when he hasn't had Draymond Green. But right now, situation calls for it.
7-point game. Gordon's got 11 in the quarter. 26 for the game. Pajemski running the point here. Gets Curry off the ball for the moment. Caldwell Pope on Curry. Tough man to shake. Curry with a little hook. No good. And Looney going to be hit with a loose ball foul. The push. And Looney picking up a couple of fouls here in the last few possessions. Fifth team foul.
Sees the two hands in the back. Jokic did a great job selling the call because he was too far under the rim.
Nikola Jokic at the line here with a chance to cut it to five, and he does so.
Which makes it another clutch game by the definition of those stats.
13-0 run. Curry, he's fouled, and Curry will go to the line. After the promo period, add it for $9.99 to a max base plan as Curry 2-for-2 from the line. Curry certainly having an MVP caliber season with a strong finish to the year. He's 9th in scoring. He's having a great year. He's got 30 tonight.
Well, he's been in a little bit of a slump, but played very well against Orlando and has had it going tonight.
Jokic gives it to Gordon. Gordon pulls his way in and a foul on Jackson Davis. A very strange, serious injury. Hand. This is his second game back.
Yeah, that's scary. And I'm a dog person. I've got three dogs at home and love animals, but that's scary.
5-point game. Gordon with 13 in the quarter after the free throws. It's a 15-2 run. Chris Paul working with Thompson. Curry, Sharitz, and Jackson Davis on the floor. Four to shoot here. Caldwell Pope disrupting. Here is Curry. Late clock. Three-pointer. No good. Jokic with the rebound. Jokic with 29, 9, and 9. Denver cannot convert.
Got a good look at a three in the corner from a 40% three-point shooter, but couldn't knock it down.
Interesting five on the floor here for Steve Kerr. Gordon's on Curry, a great defender. Jackson Davis goes strong with the left hand.
That tells you the confidence they have in this rookie to have him on the floor at the end of close games.
Four-year player at IU in Indiana. Here is Watson, sticks it. Big shot for Peyton Watson. Had a thunder dunk earlier. Now he cans a three. It's a four-point game. Two-possession lead for Golden State. Now Jokic ends up on Curry. Here's Thompson. The blow by. The runner. No good. Šarić offensive rebound. Shovels it out to Paul. Reset. KCP on Curry. Now Gordon. Curry trying to get by him. Curry, a three-pointer. Missed it badly. Gordon was all over him. Paul put it up. Too late. Won't count. Shot clock violation. Spectacular defensive stand by the Nuggets. So the Nuggets puzzle in their championship year last year.
Yeah, no question. Very versatile defender. Can guard bigger, stronger guys down low. And can guard guards out on the perimeter.
Jokic from Murray. Oh, he leaves it for Gordon. The lob from Jokic. His 10th assist of the game.
For the Nuggets this year, and a huge possession right here for both teams.
15 and a quarter for Gordon. That's a 20-4 Denver run. Gordon's got 30. Chris Paul at the controls.
Guarded by Jokic.
Wiggins back on the floor for Golden State. Got the Splash Brothers with Paul. He's going to fire the three. Missed it. Šarić. Offensive board. Lost the handle. Watson's got it.
Very interesting. They gave Chris Paul the three there. Put Jokic on him and backed up.
Denver can tie or take the lead. Gordon riding a season high right now. Watson in the corner. Good save. Six to shoot. Jokic now. Šarić on him. Jokic drops the shoulder and ties this game at 127. The Nuggets have covered an 18-point deficit. 2 seconds separating shot and game clock. Caldwell Pope on Curry. Now Jokic. And Murray with the steal. There's a clock issue there.
No, timeout. No,
I beg your pardon. So 3.6 left.
Getting it on the run going up the floor.
Jokic has it. Clock ticks. Got to put one up. Jokic for the win. Oh!
The hip. Got the hip.
Markkanen will inbound. JC surveys. Fontecchio. Flick of the wrist. And the Pura three-pointer applauded by Dunn. And Utah back to within two. Under four to play in Salt Lake. The three-win Pistons against the 15-win Jazz. Lost the handle, gathers it into Bogdanović. Shot clock runs down to five. Bogey, jumper good. Detroit goes season high in points in Salt Lake, 130. They had 66 at the half, make that 68.
It's not enough for the Jazz to get buckets. They got to get stops and buckets.
Bogdanović with 31. JC drives, he'll be at the line.
He needs.
Now he's healthy. Missed the 19 games with a calf strain. And he's flowing really free, even more so than what we saw in Detroit. Is that the east side?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, east side. Yeah, yeah. That's where he's at.
Yep.
JC out to the timeout, drops his 26th point. Jazz down two. You look at that line on JC, 19 points in the second half. AB goes to work, trailed by Sexton, jumps it, scores it. And 23 for the man we called Houdini.
Yeah. Another guy who's got a home right next to Boyan.
Missed shot by Sexton. Jesny stops as we're under three to play. Oh yes, crunch time has arrived. Detroit holding on to a four-point lead. They have their last road win, October 27th at Charlotte.
Big miss there.
You know, October's a lifetime ago. And here we are in the first week of January of 2024. JC shows the ball, jumps it, scores it. Wow, Clarkson goes for 28. And can the Jazz get over the hill? Down two. Just over 2 minutes to play.
Pistons are going to take their time and find a weakness in the Jazz's zone. Usually the middle.
Sexton slips and falls. Wide open shot. Missed by Burks. Markkanen rebounds it on the backside. Clark's in the hot hand at the moment. Markkanen lowers his shoulder. Drives. Lost the ball. Bogdanovich. Right place, right time. Strolls around the floor to burn clock. Another stop. Another stop in desperate need for the Jazz. Bogey drives in on Kessler. Stops, leans back. That ball takes a bounce out. Chased down by Simone. JC, dribble drive into the paint. Now rolls back out.
Oh, he's got a mismatch out here.
Thought about the three. Fontecchio, he'll drive in the paint. Drop it, reverse it. Walker loves that shot. He'll put it behind his head. And Utah tied with Detroit at 132.
I wonder what happened to Durant in that paint. Yes, he was probably trying to draw a foul. And Walker Kessler just wide open.
Bogey, ball kicked out.
Anything.
Jazz are in the bonus with a foul to give and two timeouts.
Bogey slips inside. It's off the rim. Rebound inside. Sexton trying to dig that ball away. He's got it. Timeout, Utah.
You don't want to rush it for a two-for-one. If you can get a good look.
Collins surveys the floor. Simone in one corner. Markkanen in the other. Now Lowry breaks down the baseline. Off to Clarkson. Shot clock five. Leans in for three. Got it! Oh, the flame is on!
Wow! Maybe a bogey coming off the screen.
Cunningham will inbound. Bogey denied by Fontecchio. Got it midcourt. Now they switch Markkanen. Bogdanovich. He goes to his left hand. Drives it home off the glass. Wooden drop. And that ball will come off the hand of Kessler. 22 seconds to play. Shot clock will jump back to 14.
See the rebound there. Yep. And it ends up rolling off of Kessler's fingers. It's close. But it does roll off of Walker's fingers.
Burks needs help. Got down to about a four count. Livers. Ball knocked away by Walker. Picked up by Bogey. Deep. Got it. Got it. Bogdanovich. Here we go. Buckle up on this Wednesday night in Salt Lake City. JC behind the three-point line. Markkanen screams out. Triples up. Got it. Markkanen tries to finish off Detroit.
No timeouts here.
AB going coast to coast. He'll throw up a prayer. Got it!
Wow.
What a game! Clutch buckets throughout the night.
The two scorers coming off the bench are not here.
Well, they've started this one with some good competitive fire. LeBron James, who did not have a three-pointer the other night, knocks down that three. He's been shooting well from three-point range for this season. Smart against Reeves. Gets in the paint, finds Biombo. And Biombo throws it up and in. Biombo, they signed November 1st. Remember, no Steven Adams this season, no Brandon Clark. Two huge, important players for this team as James drills another three. To back from downtown. Lakers by three. Morant gets away, gets inside, takes some contact, and banks it home.
Due to the break by Morant.
6 points, two assists, sits on the bench. Luke Kennard has checked in. Max Christie's come in for the Lakers. Jared Vanderbilt as well. So Zante Aldama in for Memphis.
Mike, I was looking at the Lakers on their first substitution. I think they were up one, right? Now they're gone to the bench. And this is the point where they lose quarters.
Here comes James the other way. Feeling it from three-point range. LeBron James, three for three from long distance. Tied up again. Kennard tries a three. That won't go. Christian Wood with his first minutes here in the opening quarter. James drives on Jackson. Boy, this is a different LeBron James on Wednesday night.
You can see it early.
He did not play well against the Heat. Launches and hits again. LeBron James lighting up from downtown. Taylor Jenkins not happy with his defense. And the Lakers go up by three. What a start from James. He only had 12 points Wednesday.
He was talking about players and coaches and what they think of officials this year. As Wemby knocks down the three. And he was saying one of the things that irritates him the most is that officials put up with all the chatter.
Yeah.
He said, I think guys just need to go back, hey, give me the ball, let's go play. And not being critical of any one individual, but it's like, he said, I watched the game recently, and it's like every call, someone is chatting with the official.
Oh, my goodness. Chat that.
Wemby with a three and then the oop dunk. And what a start.
And the pass was actually behind Victor, but he's so long, he was able to hang in the air. It looked like it was perfect timing.
Gives it off to Vassell.
There's another one.
Back to Wemby.
Goodness.
Oh, Mama Wembanyama!
The fans that are back in their seats in time are enjoying this dunk fest already.
And people are learning. You don't want to just stroll back into the arena when that guy's on the floor. His block is going to be called for a foul. But the Spurs have jumped on him.
And these dunks, Bill, they're demoralizing. There's a power dunk there, and here's another one. And just throw it up there, and that one's put down with authority, and it fires up.
Victor again.
Oh, oh my goodness! Stop it! Yes, thank you for the timeout! Stop that!
12 minutes to go.
Jonesy, third quarter? SGA has accounted for 26 of the 37 points scored.
Wow. Andrea Carter, sideline, talked about the adjustments that San Antonio had made in these now the second meeting against OKC. Micić missing from the wing. Holmgren hustling for the rebound. Here's the matchup we all want to see. He defers to Micić. Holmgren pulls the three, got it. And he's into double figures now with 11.
I am very curious to see if Wemby gets to finish this fourth quarter.
Goes quick against Holmgren and slammed it home. Put his shoulder into Chet. Little bully ball.
They said it's rivalry week, Jonesy. Uh-oh.
Oh, and that's going to be an offensive foul against Holmgren, who might have had payback on his mind a little bit. Let's take another look at Wembanyama's dunk.
Every action has an equal or maybe not equal reaction as Chet comes down and picks up a quick foul after that play.
Chet battling defensively, got the steal, and leads the break at 7-1. Holmgren with the lay-in. And a little payback for him. So this is where we are in 2024 then. 7'1" players leading the
point
fast
guard,
break.
Like full court, one-on-one, like it's a
feet,
drill.
Monica.
I mean, comes up with the steal, great position, and then just handles through the traffic. There's three white jerseys there.
Wow. Williams turns the corner. Good defense by Johnson. Wallace off glass, got it to fall.
I love the line that Coach Dagnall gave us in regards to Cason Wallace, who's having a terrific year out of Kentucky. He said he's so functional, we don't want to lose sight of the upside that he has, which I think is a great compliment.
Still got a high ceiling that has yet to be approached. Here's Wiggins in transition, hops through the lane and scored it.
He a Terp, Andrew Wiggins out of the University of Maryland. Shout out to my home region,
you say
hometown.
That when you said that.
You know
with,
what I'm saying? Even though I'm a Hoya, but you know, I got to give him this props.
He's switching it up. Vassell through the contact.
Dagnall makes the call. 17 points in the ball game for him. Here's Williams off the Holmgren screen. Wembanyama switched onto him. Holmgren inside, slams it home. And Holmgren has turned up the intensity dial a little bit here in the fourth quarter.
Wow. I mean, at his height, to be able to hit that second shift and get to the rim like that. Woo-hoo.
Wembanyama spins. Almost got it with the left, and not sure who tipped that in, but Wembanyama's nodding his head like, yeah, that was me.
We're going to have to ask our statistician, Stevie, to keep track on the one-on-one that's breaking out here.
Micic around the Holmgren screen. Baseline drift by Williams. He rips through. Had it knocked away right to his teammate. And Micic walked with it. That's going to be a traveling violation. 14 turnover for the Thunder as Champagne comes in for Keldon Johnson. You know, Chet Holmgren, amongst other things, an exceptional teammate. Going back to his days at Gonzaga when he got a really healthy bag of NIL money, he split it up amongst all of his teammates.
Amazing.
And if you notice his post-game media sessions, as Wembanyama is going to have something to say after the game, Holmgren likes to invite his teammates to do all of his interviews.
Oh, man, Jonesy. He does. That is sort of iconic, and it speaks to the camaraderie of this OKC squad.
Micic dancing with it, sprays it out to Holmgren. Oh, he put the big man on a flight, got it back, and tipped it home. Holmgren up to 17 now. Wembanyama with 24, and Chet has 9 in this quarter. Young man that grew up on the south side of Minneapolis, hooping with his buddies and eating jerk chicken and rice and peas afterwards. And last week, they retired his jersey at his high school in Minneapolis. The entire team showed up to support him.
Minnehaha High School. What a great high school name.
On the wing, three coming from Branham. San Antonio trying to fight its way back in the ball game, but a daunting challenge, down by 26. Branham with 9. Holmgren on the pick and pop.
Got the switch you wanted.
Spins a couple of times. Wiggins goes around the world. Tough fadeaway. Got it.
Oh, you think he's been watching his teammate a little bit on that move? Looked very SGA-esque.
12 points of the ball game for him in this battle between the youngest team in the NBA, the Spurs, and the second youngest team in the league, the Thunder. Oh, Wemby tried to take his soul away.
What is happening, Jose?
With audacity on the dunk attempt. Wiggins for 3. Got it.
Oh, my gosh.
Wembanyama with bad intentions that time.
Oh, my gosh.
This is starting to get really spicy underneath. McDermott for 3. Got it. Timeout on the floor.
Frustrating when guys like Beal are out, or Durant or Booker. Just, you need those guys.
And Gordon's not playing tonight either. You mentioned Okogie's out as well. Turnover by Hartenstein, and it ends up in a 3 for Kevin Durant. He's at 2 threes here since coming back into the game in the second quarter.
You just want him to shoot more. I mean, just want him to shoot more. Maybe I'll talk to him. Should I say something to him?
I think you should.
I mean, he used to listen to me, but maybe no more.
Brunson comes back and drills a 3. It is interesting. Durant has taken 4 threes. That's about what he takes per game. Meanwhile, Brunson with 12 points and 4 steals for the Knicks.
Durant. Did you see? I did. I said to him, the people on TV can't see it, but I signaled more threes. And, of course, he did listen.
Are people going to believe that, you think? Probably not.
No.
Probably not.
No, I don't
They
think
can't
so.
See me. They don't know. 3 threes in a row. Look at that. That's, I mean, look, we're joking, but he does need to shoot more. He just does.
I mean, he obviously can make it. Consistently a good 3-point shooter.
Look at this.
Tonight.
Look at this.
That's the 4th 3 in a row for Kevin Durant. He has the last 12 Suns points, and the game's tied with 1:50 to go in the first half.
Wow. Maybe he heard us. You think he hurt us?
Another defensive 3-second violation.
Well, Phoenix can't do that. You got to do a better defense. Look at Durant. That one for him is, that's like a layup from the corner, and here another corner three. You can't let him get in rhythm. And look, now he's comfortable, right? Made a couple in the corner. Now he's going to feel great. The basket seems huge to him.
Fourth and final meeting of the regular season between these two rivals. Here's Barnes now on the drive, pull up, air ball. Curry. And four Kings around him. Now Curry goes to the basket. Curry lays it in.
Curry might have been fouled too on that drive.
Kings go quick. De'Aaron Fox with an answer. Big three by Swipa. Herter with the rebound. Herter's got a chance at a double-double tonight. One rebound away. Fox feeling it. And Fox drills a three-pointer. Back-to-back possessions. And they have a seven-point lead. A lot of time left. 4 minutes and change. Been a terrific game tonight. We've had 43 pointers combined in this game. Here's Curry now, trying to turn the corner. Draymond Green finds Kuminga. Kuminga, bouncy, and it goes! And one for Jonathan Kuminga.
But I like that Draymond Green fouled Kuminga as he was cutting to the basket. And Kuminga with a great strength, concentration, and finish. And a few times tonight, he has had three-point play opportunities. And Kuminga continues to be effective here down the stretch. With Draymond Green, I think that was his ninth assist. Ball game.
27 for Kuminga after 25 last night. De'Aaron Fox. Sabonis now. Here is Herter. We got a whistle. It's going the other way.
Yeah, legal screen right there. Sabonis on that dribble handoff. Wiggins guarding Herter, getting over the screen. And I believe that is five fouls now on DeMontis Sabonis. Let's see if Golden State tries to go at Sabonis to pick up that sixth foul.
4-point game. Warriors with the ball trailing here. 3.5 to go. Here is Curry. Short. Miss left. Herter with the rebound. He's got a double-double tonight. 12 and 10 for Herter. Sabonis backing down Thompson. Kuminga comes to help and ties him up. Jump ball. Wins a tip right to Thompson. Springy.
You called that.
Draymond Green ducks his head into traffic. Here's Curry. He's open. Curry with a three.
And moving without the basketball right there. Curry somehow, some way got open. And his buddy Green found him.
31 for Curry, a 6-made three. Now a whistle on Thompson. Look like, how does Stephen Curry get this free?
Yeah, I don't know, but it looked like there, you know, Green got bottled up on that drive. Two guys were on him. But he was able to find Curry wide open.
Yeah, how about Sabrina Ionescu checking in? Remember Curry earlier in the game said he wants to get a three-point challenge. Sabrina's all in. I think we may have something here, Green. Good idea by you.
I think you're right.
Sabonis to Barnes. Thompson guarding Barnes. Harrison Barnes got another one. 37 for Barnes. Career high for Harrison Barnes. Curry again. Three-pointer. No good. Murray with a good closeout right there. Kings lead it by three.
On the Barnes, that's what's been working here, isolating. I wonder if they may come double team him.
Barnes against Thompson, drops the body on him, and then hits the fadeaway. 39 for Harrison Barnes. 22 field goal attempts for Barnes. He's had two massive games. Curry tracks it, lays it in. Back to a three-point game.
It's coming down to stops right here. Golden State has to get stops in this Barnes isolation. They switch Wiggins on him now. A little bit greater length and better foot speed on the perimeter defensively.
And Barnes right back to his spot. Going to work. Little turnaround. No good. Green with a rebound.
Warriors a chance to tie it right here. Curry behind the back. Curry leaves it up top. Kuminga! Sensational! Curry to Kuminga, and it's a one-point game. Fox, tough shot, he's fouled. De'Aaron Fox will go to the line. Some play, this was grand.
I mean, the ball handling right there, and then going to the rim, great recognition, and just throwing it up there for Kuminga for the easy two. It happened so quickly. Man.
With the swagger, like in a layup line or practice. This is like game crunch time moments here.
Like NBA Live.
Fox. Green on him. He'll let the three go. No, there's Kuminga with a rebound. Warriors can grab the lead. Under a minute to go. Curry gets by Herder. Stephen Curry denied from behind by Keegan Murray.
And a great block there, helping out Murray, getting that block without fouling. But obviously, the ball will be in Curry's hand here down the stretch. Curry trying to turn the corner, taking advantage of that mismatch. Blocked by Murray.
Kuminga post up. Kuminga with the throwdown. Warriors in front. First lead of the second half for Golden State. Now it's Sacramento's turn. 40 seconds left. De'Aaron Fox guarded by Curry. Fox, tough shot, in and out. Sabonis keeps it alive. Murray keeps it alive. Nice save. Herder for three in the lead. No good. Curry flips it. Wiggins, and Curry catches it on the ground, but his back was out of bounds. Kings ball. 24.1 seconds remain.
Both teams leaving it on the line. But look at this nice little screen out of bounds play. Posting up Kuminga. Man. A great pass and find Draymond Green with 11th assist. And then trying to block out here. And bodies are flying everywhere. Kings ball.
Fox will put it in. And he's Sabonis! What a play! Herder hits a cutting Sabonis.
He's playing good defense without fouling down the stretch.
The rookie Pajimski will put it in. Kuminga springs free. Kuminga with Barnes on him, just muscle his way in. It's denied by Barnes! Kings have it. The foul comes. Kuminga thought he was fouled. But a defensive stand by Sacramento when it counts.
Great double team right there as Kuminga backing down against Barnes. Sabonis came over.
I didn't necessarily see a block. Looked like Kuminga just kind of lost the ball on the way up. He was certainly in traffic. He had some contact there.
Yeah, the ball did from that angle. It did slip out of his hands. He's certainly complaining about a foul opportunity, but still, two free throws here. It's a one-possession game.
Herder misses the free throw. An 82% free throw shooter, but in the clutch. And now a one-point game could only go to two with a make here.
And I think if you're Steve Kerr, regardless of a make or miss, I think you get the ball, you push it down. Don't let the Kings defense get set by calling a timeout.
Warriors do have one left. Herder missed it, and it's Thompson with a rebound. They push it. Curry and Kuminga have combined for the last 19 points. Curry's got it. Clock ticks to three, to two. He lost it into the hands of Fox, and that's it.
But they're undefeated.
Oh, no.
Couldn't have been worse for the Celtics. Holiday. Tatum.
That's you.
Oh, that is incredible.
Those are two brilliant moves he's made.
That move was incredible.
stop saying guys are going to play good on the other team. There we go.
Hope for three. Timberwolves take a timeout.
Three half and post game.
Oh, that's good.
So if you guys want to come hang out with me and Eddie House and Amina,
come on by.
Oh, yeah. Brown
taking it right at Townsend and
Minnesota ball number 32. Carl Anthony Towns, that's his third.
Towns bringing up his third.
Jaylen Brown on the line, shooting two.
Good defense by Jaylen Brown. Physical. There you go. Big free throws right here.
72% for the season.
Slomos is gassing up Anthony Edwards, which means the ball is going to get to Anthony Edwards.
Celtics have taken 20 free throws tonight. They've made 20 free throws. Not too shabby on the other side either.
Jeez.
Has this kid come alive?
He is old, man. He is one confident young man.
Edwards will take it. Back rim, no. Edwards going to the bucket. Lost it on the way up, and
so that was blocked, but that's got to be off Anthony Edwards. Great.
We knew the rolling floor has been overturned. Ball was last touched by Minnesota. It is a successful challenge. Therefore, Boston will receive another challenge. Therefore, they will also retain their timeout.
Joe now is 19-9 on challenges this year.
Yeah. Sometimes you have to call him the Green Lantern. Mm-hmm. I'm Joe Mazzulla right here. I'm assuming they're going to go for a three-point shot. Seven with two to go. Nope.
Gets two.
Playing with design to get downhill.
Got to stop, though.
Yeah. Joe's playing the long game here.
Got to get a stop.
Oh, yeah.
Offensive foul.
The moment might be too big for somebody. Derek White, Alexander Walker, a little extra right there. Last 2 minutes, they go to the backcourt.
Tatum. Tatum takes it. Edwards. White. Tatum takes it. One minute to play. Defense!
step back.
No. Celtics ball down two.
Celtics got two timeouts left. They're going to use one right here.
The crowd.
All right, here we go. Into the corner. Tatum goes baseline. Come back, gets fouled. He'll go to the line with a chance to tie the game.
It's great work. Good job by Joe Mazzulla getting Tatum the ball. That's a good spot. Minnesota playing him straight up. Carlson Towns actually played really good defense until he left his feet right there. Two big free throws for Tatum.
81% free throw shooter. Gets it in the hands of Tatum, down one. Pushes off, passes to Horford, corner. Yeah!
That is unbelievable Celtic basketball.
Edwards. Now Brown comes to defend. Edwards. To the basket, and he's going to get to the line for two. We'll let the crowd speak for us. Tie game. Tatum. Four to shoot. Tatum takes it. Overtime. Anthony Towns. They have a chance for a three-point play. Tatum to the basket.
That's what I wanted at the end of the regulation. Just a high ball screen for Tatum to get going downhill. A lot of confusion can happen in coverages like that.
Tied at 114.
Oh, man.
Anthony Towns knock it down. A deep three to put that lead back to three. Oh, buried by your guy.
Oh, yeah.
Foul! To the basket. He gets two.
Doesn't matter.
Celtics with the steal. Holiday. Tatum takes his time. Knocks it down. Tatum.
Streak continues.
It does. It lives.
Wow.
Either, by the way.
They've been leaving him open on the floor. Let's see if he can make a big play here down the stretch.
Nice setup. Conley! Timely three by Minnesota Mike. Deja vu.
Really nice play design, too. Carl pops the catch. Rudy sets that cleanup screen for Mike.
James behind the back to Davis. Little push off on Gobert and cans the mid-range J. 30 points, 15 rebounds for Davis. Second 30-15 game of the season. Conley leaves it for Edwards.
Three ball, corner pocket. Ant has 28. Reeves around a Davis screen. Stripped by Conley. Quickly ahead. McDaniels can't chase it down. Vanderbilt quick feet. James, no hesitation. And we have a pigeon, ladies and gentlemen.
You don't ever see the pigeon. It's up on the cameras up there, too, boy. That is stuck up there. Nice job, LeBron. He's come alive here.
Eight in the quarter, trying to add to it. Fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. And he's rubbing that left foot. 100-95. If Ant knocks down both free throws, it will be Minnesota's largest lead of the ball game. Not including last year's play-in game, the Wolves have won four of the last five meetings with LA, as we get a message from Trio Orthopedics.
For some of our patients, the goal is hoisting the trophy, but you just want to hoist your grandkids. At Trio Orthopedics, we'll treat that knee so you can be there to lift them up.
Edwards has 10 of the last 13 points for Minnesota. The lead is 7. James on an island with Towns. Gonna penetrate right down the lane. And the flush from the ageless LeBron James. Under two.
Kind of want to keep my matchup of LeBron.
Conley over to Towns. Towns on the drive and is fouled by LeBron. First free throws of the night for Karl Anthony Towns. As a team, the Wolves are 18 for 21. Towns shaking off a rough night. Two big free throws. Lead is 7. Here comes his target center crowd. Davis thought about the three. James turns the corner, retreats on an island with Gobert now. Gonna drive down the lane, kick out. Davis deep, got it. Huge three from Anthony Davis, who has 33. Still a two possession ball game. A bucket here would be huge. Edwards. Pull up from deep, short, Gobert offensive board. Taps it to Conley, fresh 14. Edwards on the logo, wants an iso. Penetrate, inside, blocked by Davis, who saves it to Reeves. LeBron now, down the lane. Vanderbilt missed the shot, Towns has it. Quickly ahead to Edwards, who's gonna chew clock. Conley. All day, cash! Reeves to work it in. 35 seconds to go on regulation. James. And he is fouled.
Wow.
And that's going to be the end of the night for Jaden McDaniels. And did they just get a technical? Could not be worse timing.
Did not be handsy. and he's trying to show his hands, and it's just frustration for him.
So now this game is tightened up with 31 seconds remaining, and LeBron at the line to make it a one possession game.
Yeah. And if you're the Lakers too, you don't need to foul here. There's enough differential.
Yep. If the Wolves miss, Lakers will get the ball back and a chance to tie this ball game and send it to OT.
That's a big technical foul, man. That made
huge.
A one possession game.
Big offensive possession here for Minnesota. Conley using the Gobert screen. Gobert down the lane, left it for Anderson. Kick out. Conley again. Short. Rebound. Davis quickly ahead. LeBron for three. Got it. No, they're calling it a two. It is a two. They will review it. On his 39th birthday, he might be inches away from tying this ball game up. We'll take another look. Officials said two. Let's take a peek.
Ruling on the floor, 2 point field goal. The play is under review.
And gets it ahead to Edwards, who is immediately fouled by Vanderbilt. And at the moment, there's 1.4. To get it in, finds James. James did not get it off in time. No foul called. Wolves survive. 108-106.
And the Spurs lead by one. Kelvin Johnson goes into Connaughton. 50% shoot for the Spurs with a nice fake, but now he's doubled down low and kicks it out in the corner. Jones drives over Connaughton. Got it. It's a three-point lead for the Spurs.
Got to come back with Victor at some point. Got a three-point lead.
Here he comes. He's getting off the bench, just as you said that. We're clairvoyant.
Winnable game here.
Lillard's had a big fourth quarter. Keldon Johnson will be the defender. It's Connaughton against Houseman. Shot clock at three and across the lane. The ball knocked away. And it is off the Bucks.
Great job there by Jetty Osman, and fantastic minutes as Victor Wembanyama back on the floor here to close this ball game up with the Spurs up three and just a shade under four left.
Osman is out. Popovich has made the move. 23 points and 8 rebounds for Wembanyama, and here comes Keldon Johnson. Lopez again. We'll watch Wembanyama. This is Vassell. Oh, and he'll follow with a jam. And he's just given San Antonio their biggest lead tonight of 5.
Again, we can't tell you enough. This Milwaukee team has struggled on the road.
Wow.
And Giannis.
And a free throw to try to complete the three-point play and go for 35. Two-point game. 3.5 to go.
What a big bucket and free throw there by Giannis. Here's the zone for Milwaukee.
The Gumbo with a good feed and a shove inside. It was on Lopez.
And Victor through the free throw line here.
Wembanyama is 4 of 4 from the stripe.
I can't say that. You know, he's perfect from the free throw line. You got to,
well, what's worse?
You actually saying to the basketball gods he's 4 for 4.
I'm just reporting what's going on.
Right.
I'm a simple-minded broadcaster. Here comes Antetokounmpo, and Wembanyama is in the way, and they clear it out. Now they'll step back and take a three. Giannis drains it. 38 for Antetokounmpo with a beautiful tray.
But again, you'll live with that.
Here's Vassell. Big night for him. 34 points. Wembanyama, he'll take a three. Rebound. Victor inside the crash. And the foul.
That's an offensive foul.
It goes on Wembanyama. He's got five.
Nice job there.
It sure was.
Giannis.
It was.
Taking that charge.
Lillard will take it and shifting through traffic. Wide open three out of the Kumbo.
Oh, that was a killer. 9-1 Milwaukee run is the...
And a trip to NBA All-Star 2024. Vote daily on the NBA app or at NBA.com/vote. 9-1 run by the Bucks. Two threes by Giannis coming in this fourth. Sohan a shot. No. Rebound inside. Claimed by Lillard. 2 minutes to play. Lillard and Giannis Antetokounmpo, Reggie, have the last 22 Milwaukee Buck points.
We're at 66 points right now between the two.
Keldon Johnson is watching Antetokounmpo, and outside Connaughton, three in and out. Keldon Johnson the rebound.
This is the time when Devin Vassell has to make a play for this team.
Johnson will drive. Beasley will defend. Basket, no. Rebound Connaughton. Couple misses right there by the Spurs.
This kind of shows you the youth and the inexperience and not having a true closer on this team.
Lillard drives into Sohan. Wembanyama wipes it away with a rejection. It's Jones racing the other way. Vassell, Wembanyama, three. Good! We are tied!
Wemby is doing it at both ends of the floor. Four block shots and two made threes.
27 for Wembanyama. Antetokounmpo outside, under a minute to go. Giannis drives, drops the sledgehammer. Woo, wow, 43.
What a game.
And hit back to back here in the closing moments of this fourth.
Nice stroke, 3-point play, 3-point Bucks lead.
And you don't need a three here if you're San Antonio. Get a good quality look, and then you're going to have to trust your defense.
Antetokounmpo's got 14 here in the fourth. Jones tries and kicks. Sohan, triple. Rebound, Giannis Antetokounmpo, 14.
That's a great look.
Lillard the other way, half minute to go.
They have to send help. There's no way that Jones is going to be able to guard him.
The screen, the drive. Oh, it's knocked away by Wembanyama. Knocked away by Wembanyama. Timeout, San Antonio.
And extended minutes for Victor, right? Up to 26.
Wembanyama has five blocks. Antetokounmpo has three.
Oh, this is what I would do is, if you can get a quality three, sure, you go for it. But if you can get a quick two, you assume that the Bucks are going to call a timeout to get Giannis out the game.
Trey Jones has it. Lillard defends. It's Vassell. Down to seven. Off to Wembanyama to tie. Jones, no! Rebound off of San Antonio and 1.8 there, and Trey Jones had a chance to tie it with that three. Bucks are on top by three, and Connaughton keeps it there with the miss. Connaughton is 73% free throw shooter. 0-1 at the line. Got that big one to make it a 4-point game, and we've got an illegal inbound by San Antonio.
By Victor.
And Milwaukee has the ball. It's a violation on
San Antonio.
On the Spurs. And that'll do it. And Giannis and Lillard scored 25 consecutive Bucks points to secure the win. And they've scored 25 of the last 26.
Playing good defense against him. He's not just losing it. He's just making good moves, getting just enough separation, hitting shots over the top.
Two and a half left, down four. Curry down the lane. Curry flipping it up and in.
I have no idea how he scored that with that much contact.
Dort is hurt.
Dort is down.
Dort is grabbing his left ankle. Lou Dort is hurt. Gilgeous Alexander is dribbling through the Warrior defense. They're playing 4-on-5. Dort is hustling into the front court, but he's not moving well at all.
They're going to go timeout.
They have to.
Wow.
2:14 left. Steph Curry is wondering how he was not fouled on that last play. He does not complain all that often, but with all the contact and all the bodies flying, he can't believe that wasn't an and one on that layup.
You think about some of the fouls that Shai Gilgeous-Alexander has got. It's an amazing move. Yanked.
He's fouled
Aaron
right
Wiggins,
there.
That's a foul. Dort came in to help.
That's not even close. I mean, Dort gets the side of his body right there.
There's enough contact there.
My goodness.
Again, comparing it to the contact we've seen called fouls in this game, you would think that's a foul, but no, Steph somehow concentrated and still got that one up. Sometimes it's like that on the road. Just got to play through the contact.
I'm telling you, I say it a lot, and I say it because it's true. I've never seen an elite player that gets less of a whistle than Steph Curry. It's amazing to me. Like, that's not a hard call. You can call that from the 30th row of the building.
Steph is built for it, though. Built his body up.
So Jalen Williams, 6 of 6 in the fourth quarter. He's got 12 of his 26 here in the fourth. Dort is out of the game. So Isaiah Joe with Aaron Wiggins, Chet Holmgren, Jalen Williams, and Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. And Dort may have to go to the locker room.
He needs some big-time stops now. You know it's going to be Shai Gilgeous-Alexander or Jalen Williams attacking.
Thunder, 2-point lead in the ball. Shai wants to call his own number. Steph knocked that away, went right to Holmgren. Only one to shoot, and he didn't get it off. It's a 24-second violation. How about that Warrior defense?
The Thunder looked a little indecisive there, and you could tell the Warriors were ready for it. They went over that action in practice, made sure Draymond came over to help so they could figure out where to drive it. Stayed home on the ball screens. Perfect.
Down 2 inside of 2 minutes. Clay comes free for the lead. Got it!
Oh.
He bottoms a 3!
Draymond set an amazing screen. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander tried to shoot the gap. Got just enough separation. Now you're in a zone if you're the Warriors.
1-2-2 zone. Clay at the top. They don't want to allow any drives. And here comes Jalen Williams trying to drive the zone. Draymond was there. Rebound loose. Kuminga!
You just take your time, get something great. High percentage shots.
Remember, Dort's not in. So Steph not guarded by Dort. Gets Holmgren on a switch. Curry dropping to Kuminga. Shot clock at 7. JK couldn't reverse it up and in. Shai with the scattered floor. This is where he wants to go. All the way to the rim to lay it in.
Just on-ball defense.
Final minute. Oh, dangerous pass. Warriors fortune. Isaiah Joe touched it last.
Just have to be careful.
4:30, 4:39. We got tons of possessions left, but can you continue to get stops?
Grace with 9 threes ties his season high with 9 that he had against Miami in that victory. Suns get that stop. KD on the drive. Looks inside. Extra pass. Durant from distance.
You got to keep the pace high. That's why they're being successful right now. They have the Kings on their heels. The pace is in our favor.
This is when all of a sudden now all that bravado gets a little tough and tight.
As close as the Suns have been, offensive foul on Barnes.
He did, too. He turned. He handed the ball off, and he turned right into Devin Booker. But, Sophie, that's all because Devin is working hard. Like, the only reason he got that foul, look how he's fighting. No, look. That's how you get the call. And, like, Josh Okogie does that all the time.
Absolutely, and going back to the fast breaks, it is hard, but winning is hard, and they're being successful at hard things right now, and that's what you got to do to get back on the winning train a little bit. I know we won the past two, but Darling.
Katie, the quick catch and shoot. Kings had dropped into a little zone on that last possession.
Yeah, Katie had a great look there, without a doubt.
Here is Monk. Sabonis.
Got to be ready to help.
Monk turns the corner, drives inside. Blocked by Allen. On the push to Beal. Beal brings the boom. Suns within seven.
Yeah, watch De'Aaron Fox now. That he is the one that tries to take over in these situations. One of the best fourth quarter players in the game.
Earned the first ever clutch award last season as Booker with a collision there.
Look at Grayson. I mean, he hung up there and just took that away. And then the great pass. And you see the athleticism of Bradley Beal right there.
But you know what that started with is them communicating on the defensive end. It gives them confidence to get up on the ball handlers and the shooters. Great defensive stop led to great offense.
Durant stepping out on Fox. Sidestep three, Durant with a block. Suns on the run. Book trailing. Back to KD. Beyond the arc. Splashdown. A four-point game. This place is rocking.
And the Kings look disheveled.
Phoenix run. Monk on the drive. Sabonis.
Keep the pace high, though. We'll take that. Keep the pace high. Keep it moving.
You heard the call. 2 minutes. Gordon thought about it. Able to draw the foul. He was caught between trying to drive and trying to shoot the three. That's just the... Well, because we're under two. A foul to give for the Suns. None for Sacramento. 1:54 to go.
So the Suns can get to the free throw line here. Just got to be aggressive. Give some up fakes, too, because they're going to go for them.
Beal off the inbound. Push to the baseline out of bounds. That is the 20th Phoenix turnover.
Can't put your head down now. The climb has been too good. Yeah. 1:51 left. Two possession game. But you got to get stopped. Can't let them score.
Bonus with the screen. Monk throws it away.
No, I tell you, see, they got him disheveled. Like, and the Kings have done this over the last couple of years to where if you make a run at them, all of a sudden.
Booker going after Sabonis. Allen, touch pass. Gordon with the hit.
This lineup has been a problem for the Kings.
Let's see. Point game.
Let's see. Now Fox is the one that fights through all of this.
Sabonis with a screen. Murray, they'll own the offensive glass.
That hurt.
Could have been a moving screen, too, though, on Sabonis right there.
And the Suns get two stops.
Fox with a pull-up three. No. Back tap. Suns have got it. Got to get it across. Suns with an advantage. Gordon from the corner. Splashdown. Gordon goes. Boom. We're tied at 1:15.
Don't foul.
Fox with a pull up.
No, that's a foul on Sabonis.
And there's the whistle.
He called it. This place is awesome right now.
Tell you what. And they're in the bonus. Look. The lineup that Vogel went to, without a doubt, with KD at center.
had been the turning point. And
well, that and the intensity that that group.
Right. Just the desire to just feel ashamed.
.9 left.
And they only have one timeout, so they're not going to call it. The Suns just have to understand, they will take the three. You got to make them put the ball on the floor and get inside the three.
Fox on the drive.
Bull is not going to call a timeout here.
117 all in the hands of Bradley Beal.
But if you're the Suns, you want to make sure that you get the last shot.
KD on the pull-up.
Foul.
Foul by Fox with 1.6.
I mean, Allen's been really the only consistent one. Durant's come alive.
This is an amazing comeback. Amazing. They can't challenge.
Let's go back and look at the play.
That's a foul. Come on, De'Aaron Fox. Stop. Now they got a timeout though, so
they'll advance.
And if you're the Suns, you definitely want to make sure when they get the ball. You want to make sure that they do not get a three up. Like, you've got to really guard the three. Well, you want to make sure that foul is with his back to the basket. You do not want to reach in and foul when they can face you and shoot it.
And keep an eye on Harrison Barnes, the inbounder. Monk gets it away. Off the glass. Suns with what looks like an improbable rally.
Wow.
Go on a 32-8 run.
Wow.
But they don't have a timeout to call the challenge. Nine points in the fourth quarter for Giannis. He leads the league in terms of points per game in the fourth quarter this year. He goes 3 for 4 here down the stretch, final few seconds. A two-point lead. Giannis off the glass there for Fox to tie it at 128. 2.1 left. Giannis to take it out. Giannis to Dame. Dame for the win. Launches it. We head to overtime.
He's got the surface for the Bucks. Still your venue. Still your basketball game. But you got to go out here and grab it because this is a confident Kings team who wants to snap a 14-game losing streak.
To the Bucks. It'll be Bucks basketball after that first possession. And meanwhile, the Bucks looking to go three straight to end this homestand. A win against the Celtics last night against Golden State. Possibly a win here tonight against Sacramento.
It used to be that the team that could string together two consecutive baskets in overtime, this is before the plethora of three-point shots, had a really good, really high chance of winning the game.
Giannis with four here to shoot. Between the legs, pulls up for about 15 out.
That possession had trouble written all over it.
Fox is looking for it, works around that screen. There's the first bucket of overtime.
Giannis on Fox, tough for Giannis to fight through that screen set by, I think it was Sabonis, and just a wide open elbow jump shot.
Brook looking for PC in the corner. Bucks still looking for their first points of the extra session. Fox pulls up. They're looking for a errant closeout and a foul. He said he got hit on the arm.
He did. Dame gave him a little snake bite right on the release.
Three and a half to play. Giannis going right at it. Gives it up last second to Malik Beasley. Dame trying to break it up. Monk, runner. Malik Monk, 26 points.
There's your two consecutive buckets, but again, with the way teams are able to shoot three-point shots.
And Fox picks the pocket of Dame. Adrian Griffin forced to call the timeout.
Pay you for a year.
Dame pump fake, steps right behind the three-point line and drills it. A much-needed bucket in overtime.
Talk about poise. That was a tough kind of Iverson cut catch. Going away from the basket for Dame Lillard. But this guy here in the mid-range has been murdered.
Sabonis with a key offensive rebound gives it to Monk. Giannis have one timeout left.
Because that same play that worked that last possession. Aaron Fox playing it differently. Going to top lock Dame, not allow him to catch the basketball.
Giannis with six to shoot. Pat Connaughton, much needed. He responds, ties it at 134.
Connie's corner open for business. They send two at Giannis. Pat does a great job finding his opening in Connie's corner and knocking down the shot.
Pump fake. Fox is cool as a cucumber.
Gets you off your feet, gets to his spot, which is that mid-range jump shot going to his left.
Dame comes back to get it. To his left. Back to Dame in the corner. Fox reaches in from behind. Number four.
Gives the Bucks a 14-second reset. Imagine the fatigue factor for both Giannis and Dame in a game like this. Dame at 40 minutes, Giannis at 39, the second night of a back-to-back. You got to suck it up and make it happen. No rest for the weary.
Trailing by two, Dame lets it fly. He's got three free throws coming. Third best free throw percentage in the league. The fourth most free throw made in the league per game. Two for two on this trip. Five for five for the game. A big one to give the Bucks the lead, 137 to 136. The Bucks on a 9-2 run.
Dame with the no dribble free throws knocks down a big three.
Herter from up top. He's had answer after answer from behind the three-point line.
That's a tough shot. I mean, guys, it has not shot the ball well this season, but you know he's capable.
He's got 6 3-pointers tonight. Bucks trailing by two, that's for the lead.
And all of Pfizer form up on their seats on that release by Dame. Had a pretty solid look off of it.
Monk that time broken. Dame trying to draw the foul and get the call. Dame coming around, it's a three-pointer on the way.
At any rate,
coming over to get it right back. He's an 88% free throw shooter coming into tonight. He's missed three, though, from the foul line. Missed them both. An opportunity. Window is tight. Here comes Giannis. Brooks checks his feet, fires, he hits! It's a one-point.
Aggressively trying to overplay, get a steal if you can, but.
And I think Sacramento got a timeout in time before the foul.
To play on his part.
Lyles is the guy you want to foul. He's the inbounder. He's a 63% free throw shooter. They get it to Fox. Time is ticking. And they stop the clock with 5.2. Fox is a 72% free throw shooter coming into tonight. Beasley's fifth.
Oh boy.
That's got to go.
Two to tie, three to win. 5.2 left. No timeouts left for the Bucks. Here comes Dame. 3 seconds. Dame pulls for the win.
Oh,
Dame time is alive and well in Milwaukee.
Dame time. Pelicans lead is 6. Moran holding, rises up, and a finger roll to put it down. Just explosive off the bounce. And when most players jump, you feel like they hit a plateau. And then Moran has that extra bump in it. Desmond Bane lays it in. This is a two-point game now. Grizzlies in the bonus the rest of the way here. Jackson has attempted 11 free throws. He's got a career high going in free throw attempts per game. Been more active in the paint. Grizzlies, despite getting Ja Morant back, still shorthanded. Steven Adams out for the year. Brandon Clark, Achilles injury. Marcus Smart hopeful to return soon, as is Kennard, as is Rose. But they are shorthanded, and it has been a rough season. Able drops Bane and hits the jumper.
Beautiful move there. Bane kind of lost his footing.
McCollum guards Bane. He's hit a couple of threes in this half. Jackson with the four fouls. Drives on Williamson, runs into a wall, missed it. Ingram rips the rebound away from his teammate. Pelicans lead is 4. 4 minutes to go in regulation. Ingram throws it into fifth gear. Brandon Ingram. Back-to-back possessions with jumpers.
A la Durant. Once he gets to his spot, just not a lot you can do with it.
Jackson from Bane hits a three. Nice setup, and the big man drills a three-pointer.
And how about the ebbs and flow in this game, particularly in the fourth quarter? Both teams throwing haymakers.
Jackson's got 22. It's his first made three. That was denied. Williamson was going up top. With a deflection on the pass. With Morant stumbles his way in, but a foul is called, and Morant's going to the line.
And this play here, Brandon Ingram there just able to create the space. And then this one just fading away. And that's a nice find there by Bane and Jackson to knock down that triple to keep this game connected. And fans didn't like that one, but it looked like B.I. swiped down on the ball. And Morant, very clever at selling those plays.
Ingram picks up his third foul. Valanciunas is going to re-enter for Zeller. And another free throw coming for Morant. Wow, what a game here tonight. In our last night of 2023 on
TNT. Ja Morant's return has been a roaring success. He's got 28 points. It's a one-point game.
He has been about as good as you could have expected if you're Taylor Jenkins.
Ingram guarded by Vince Williams. Ingram turn around. There's a foul. And Ingram will shoot a pair. Just has the great ability at 6'8", all that length, shifty as he is, as proficient as he is at the mid-range. He's such a major weapon for the Pelicans.
He is, and I like how they got him the ball there with a live dribble in that mid-post area, because that's an area where it's really difficult to double.
Brandon Ingram, add one more, 34 points. GA, he started 1 for 7, but he knows his role on this team as one of the primary scorers, and he didn't stop shooting, and he hasn't hardly missed. Lost challenges, so no challenges available, and no more fouls to give the rest of the way. A terrific stat, folks, looked up this note. Players who have missed 25 or more games in their return game. Ja Morant has the most points ever scored in a return game after missing 25 or more. Chris Webber and Derek Fisher had that mark at 26. Two-point game. Memphis with a three could take the lead. Five to shoot here. Jackson to Morant. Got to go quick. Morant with Williamson on him. The three-pointer no good. Valanciunas clears it away. Under three to go in regulation. Brandon Ingram guarded by Williams. Now the switch. Valanciunas kicks it. Jones drives. Zion Williamson left him some room, but Jones missed it. Another chance here for Memphis. And Bane gets by Williamson all the way around the horn. Ja passed it up. Runs into Valanciunas, lost the handle. A Memphis turnover. McCollum will get it organized. Now Williamson. Double team comes. Here's Ingram now. Valanciunas and Morant knocked it away. Throws it off of Zion. Memphis ball.
And how about the effort there by Ja Morant? Just doesn't give up on that play. And then the presence to gather and get the deflection off of Zion for the possession.
And a third opportunity here for Memphis to tie or take the lead. Under 2 minutes to go and a foul on Ingram. Ingram and Jackson get tied up. That'll be number four on Brandon Ingram.
And that's a huge play for a few reasons. One, Ja Morant is gassed right now. And for him to be able, in essence, to get a mini timeout here, and they get an opportunity at two free throws to potentially tie this thing up.
Taylor Jenkins walked over to Morant. He's got his hands on his knees and said, you good? Morant's not good now.
He doesn't want to foul. Come out. Well, I think he can sense the moment, right? He knows right now they got a little momentum, a little more uncertainty from New Orleans' standpoint. And he's just trying to see if they can steal one here on the road.
We are tied. Memphis down 19 at the half. 14 in the quarter for Jackson. McCollum airballs it. And now Memphis with the ball can take the lead here.
And that possession, again, it allows Morant to kind of just get his win, because they had him on Herb Jones on that weak side corner where he didn't really have much to do. Wasn't a part of the action there.
Grizzlies trying to take the lead on the road. Bane, two Pelicans on him, leaves Morant open. Six to shoot now. Here goes Morant in the paint. Morant rises up and gives Memphis the lead. Their first since the first quarter. Not sure what the whistle was. Inadvertent whistle is what
I think they
like.
Thought there was a timeout being called by New Orleans, and there wasn't. So they'll just hit the reset there. But what a huge possession there. And Ja able to just kind of walk down the lane there for his floater.
9-1 run for the Grizzlies. Now the Pelicans behind, and Zion! No, but Valanciunas with the follow!
And great adjustment there by Willie Green, involving Ja Morant in that pick and roll, not allowing him to kind of take the possession off defensively.
Morant drives, Morant lays it in to give Memphis the lead. Back quickly, here's Jones, drives, and he lays it in! Pelicans pushing after the made basket.
That was a great play by C.J. McCollum to kick that ahead to create that angle of attack for Irv Jones.
Coming down to the finish line now. Morant, step back three, no!
One you would probably like him to attack with knowing they're in the penalty, but he also gave him a 2-for-1 here, so they'll get another possession.
Brandon Ingram with Vince Williams on him. Morant stalking. Here's McCollum. He's open. The three. No good. Missed it badly again. And now the shot clock is off. 9.6 seconds remain.
To attack the rim.
Memphis, no timeouts left. Into the backcourt it goes. Morant's going to get ahead of steam with a chance to win it in his return. Here goes Morant. He spins. Morant scores! And the timer expires. Count the basket. And Ja Morant wins it for the Grizzlies. Show-stopping performance by Ja Morant.
Holiday will make a move, and it's a three. Curry's got it. Into Tatum, up and down. Tatum and Kuminga, shot clock at five. Off to White, over Curry, three.
Good. Why not? Why not? Derek White has been on one all evening.
Each team has hit 15 threes. Moody aggressively into Horford. 10 for him. Curry the other way.
Man, how big would a Curry 3 be in a situation like this?
Driving by White, knocked away by Horford. What a rejection by Horford. It's picked up. White, the pump, the drive, and the foul.
Well, there's one thing that Al Horford hasn't lost is his sense of timing. Always been a great defensive player.
Saric picked up his second foul. White is at the free throw line. First trip tonight for Derek White, an 89% free throw shooter.
It's the Harlan Jinx right there. Mm-hmm. Every time I'm with you, it's the Harlan Jinx.
All you had to say was his first trip to the free throw line. You threw out the percentage, and we saw what happened.
Jackson Davis will come in for Saric. Chris Paul is in with Curry and Thompson and the rookie, Jackson Davis and Kuminga. That's the Golden State Five. White, Horford, Brown, Tatum, Holiday for the C's. White.
27 for Derek White.
Golden State bench has outscored the Boston bench tonight. No surprise, one of the best benches in the league. Look at Curry zigzagging. Thompson free to fire.
That was all Stephen Curry. His ability to create offense for his splash brother, Klay Thompson.
Golden State, their 14th straight game, within 5 points in the last 5 minutes. They've done it again, and now within four. Foul on Paul.
That's just beautiful. Beautiful playmaking and a beautiful follow-through stroke there by Klay Thompson.
Brown is at the line. 22 games played where scoring margin was within 5 points at some point in the final 5 minutes of regulation. Most in the NBA, and now it is 23. Brown at the stripe. NBA All-Star voting presented by AT&T is now open. You help decide who goes to Indianapolis this February or to St. Elmo's. Every vote with your NBA ID gives you a chance to win a trip to NBA All-Star 2024. Vote daily on the NBA app or at NBA.com/vote.
Oh, can't wait to kiss the ground when I get home to my Hoosier homeland.
It's Paul, an open lane.
Boston
off the bench for Chris Paul.
And Boston messing with fire here. Letting these Warriors hang around.
Chris Paul's made four in a row. Approaching three to play. Brown, the collision, foul called on Jaylen Brown.
Great defense. And everybody held their breath to see what the call would be.
I think they may challenge this. Joe Mazzulla was looking at his assistant.
That was a textbook charge in the chest.
Yep, look at that right arm. It was extended.
Extended arm.
Good call there by the official.
Golden State starting the beginning of a three-game homestand. 9 of 10 will be here. Curry, long three.
And you got to be up on the screen if you're Hal Horford.
Here from Sausalito. It's a one-point game.
Oh, man. Here we go.
Curry, 4 of 4 in the fourth quarter. Under three to go. In the corner, it goes to Holiday, working on the rookie center. Drew Holiday across the lane. Foul. It's going on the Warriors with...
But I kind of like his last three. Maybe the pose. He stood there and posed.
I personally like the pose.
Yes.
Because he lets the crowd speak for himself. But I also like the look away.
Look away is the best. It's so disrespectful, too, right? One possession game here, Mr. Harlan.
Boston has got two fouls to give and two timeouts. Golden State, no fouls to give. They've got a single timeout. To Paul Thompson, three. That ties the game at 118. Klay Thompson has buried six threes.
Gotta remember who you are.
That's White. Kuminga there. Shot clock at 8. Tatum and Curry. Curry with 5 fouls. Double by Kuminga. White, free to fire. Good! Derek White.
And I don't know if that's the guy that you double off. I think he's proven that he's knocking down the three tonight.
Especially tonight, as you just mentioned. But what are you going to do with the 5 fouls on Curry?
7 threes for White. 30 points for the Celtics. Curry, step back, triple. Oh! Oh,
oh. He's on one. What a game here. Old-fashioned shootout.
13 fourth-quarter points for Stephen Curry. White back the screen. White the three. Rebound Tatum. Kuminga comes up on him. Shot clock at 7. Triple. No. Rebound inside. Picked up by Holiday. White for the lead. No on the three. Rebound Boston. 1 minute to go. In the corner, Brown drives and can't get it. Horford tipping, no, loose inside, picked up by Jackson Davis.
Oh my goodness, how many wide open looks, Candace, did the Celtics get right there? He puts fear in people's heart, people.
Curry and Horford. Holiday comes out, 3 for the lead. Out of bounds it goes. It's Golden State's ball.
You couldn't have asked if you're Stephen Curry.
For a better look.
For a better look, because he had Al Horford leaning. They're going to challenge this.
Boston wants a timeout. Celtics, top team in the East. It's Tatum for the lead. No. Overtime.
Great one-on-one defense there by Jonathan Kuminga. Bringing him back. Do or die. And he's played with those 5 fouls.
It's the third overtime game for both teams in this young season. Both teams knocked away. Kuminga with the steal and the two. Curry trying to shed the D, finding Thompson. White goes on him. Inside. Jackson Davis. Here comes Brown. Takes it.
This place would have gone crazy if he would have knocked down that three.
Here comes Jaylen Brown, the crash of the ball to work down the lane, and he gets the deuce.
Beautiful move there by Brown.
Curry down the lane. Timeout Celtics.
Stepping up here.
No changes out of that break. Jaylen Brown across the lane, Horford in the corner, three, got it! 10 second difference, game clock, shot clock, Curry, spinning, corkscrew move, inside, no! Paul gathers it in, clock at three, Curry, three!
Oh, oh, there's the meme!
What a shot! Thirteen rebounds tonight, a new high. Here comes Holiday, shot away. Golden State wins in overtime by six.
And now the struggles again for the Celtics on the road, Candace.
Maybe just get the ball to Şengün on the elbow and get out the way.
Marks it.
And you got to get a stop.
For him. As the Jazz go up two. 11 of 21, 9 boards, 4 assists as well for Clarkson. Şengün with the right hand, no good. And the rebound of Utah. All right, it's getting a little nerve-wracking here.
Yeah,
70 did. Seconds to play.
Likely going to have to get off the glass, but we talk about the defense of the Rockets.
Clarkson, he's been hot. Misses that three. Gets his own rebound. Now to Sexton. Back to Clarkson, one-on-one here with Green. Jaylen's been on the bench a long while. Markkanen, short. Kessler tapped it to himself.
You can't leak out.
And a timeout to Utah. Şengün back in, quick roll on Kessler. Got there, couldn't finish, got his own miss. Put it up, oh! Goodness, it almost dropped, but he was fouled. There's the first. Tie game.
All right, got to get a stop. See if the Rockets elect to stay in their coverage or if they switch this pick and roll.
Crowd on their feet. Shot clock is off. If the Jazz make a shot here, they can make it and take it with no time left to win the game. Clarkson. Working baseline, doubled up to Sexton. Sexton a little hit to the old, getting up, misses, rebound Brooks, and we got overtime. Marketed. Goes glass, first points since the start of the fourth quarter. Pull up for Smith, got it.
Seen Jabari take over in situations like this. That's the shot you need to remain confident. Now you got to get a stop here.
And away from the ball, underneath the basket, Jabari Smith called for an elbow on Lauri Markkanen.
Their deficit.
Yeah, that three-point lead they just had was their biggest of the game. They were down by as many as 17. Markkanen into Kessler.
No communication there. In between switching or staying home, there's no weak help there on the weak side. And it's Kessler getting buckets here in overtime.
Jabari into Şengün, tough catch, even tougher on the finish.
Hey man, coach is giving the green light to Jabari, playing between him, through him and Şengün. And you know Jabari, if you don't know anything about him, he's not scared of the moment.
32 for Şengün, 21-9, and the first assist of the game for Jabari Smith Jr. Dribble handoff. Clarkson pressured by Brooks. Sexton drives. Wrap around, blocked from behind. And Markkanen was there.
He's out of bounds.
I think it was Kessler who had the ball, came down with it, out of bounds. Houston gets it back and a chance to get the lead back again. This winning ways, that's one of the best plus-minus figures in the league. Obviously, we saw the guy who was number one in the league in that
department. How about Şengün? He stole the tip. He read where it was going.
And spins on Fontecchio and dunks it down.
Huge play. It's the hustle from Şengün. And we talked about that's what's needed here from the Rockets with no Fred. Fred fouls out in regulation.
Sexton fouled.
And it's so tough to guard, man. Sexton, he just created so much contact downhill.
So makes the first. So if the trend continues, we'll see what happens. Jazz back up three. A 1:59 to play in overtime. Utah 22-21. The Rockets 19-21, going 1-5 on the road trip. The Jazz have won 12 of their last 15. This is that. Rebound Houston.
Wow, Sexton just crashed from half court, man.
There. Jabari from the free throw line. Jabari knocks it down from the free throw line.
He's fearless.
23-10 for Smith. Off the pick, Sexton tried to throw it back, nearly threw it away, dove on the ball, and the Jazz are going to get a timeout.
Wow.
Corner inbound, tough spot, into
Markkanen,
who dunks it down.
That was a play. I mean, that was a beauty of a play from Utah. Taking advantage of the switching from the Rockets.
126-123. Two on Şengün. They try to take the ball out of his hands. Finds a wide open Whitmore. The corner three dances off. Rebound. Kessler took it away from Thompson. And then threw it back. And Thompson stole it back. And then he was denied.
Kessler. Wow. You talk about value.
What a presence Kessler is around the rim.
Offensive foul.
That's an offensive
foul. There you go.
Inside of a minute to play. Back to Şengün, rolling in and getting to the cup. And there was a foul. And he can tie the ball game up here with a free throw.
Oh, my goodness. Love Şengün.
Seconds to play. Oh, he got it. Game is tied at 126. He has tied his career high, has Şengün with 37.
And the Rockets have needed every bit of 37. Send that man to the All-Star game.
Again, the fans on their feet. Two on Clarkson. Now to Sexton. Gets by Brooks, who may have held him. They didn't call it. And now they do call a foul on Utah. This to break the tie. One for two. Remember, the Rockets are over the foul.
Yeah, he's on one leg. He's got to come out, man.
And he is going to come out.
This play. He's taking marketing.
Into Fontecchio. Back to Sexton. Working on Holiday. Gets into his body. Got there. There comes Thompson from the weak side to block it away.
Hey, listen. Rockets don't need to do anything crazy. Take their time here. Don't turn it over. Amin Thompson with the block, man.
Great defense by the Rockets rookie. So it'll be Dylan Brooks on the far side of the floor.
Mike Kessler's got five.
And he's back out there for Olynyk.
See, Dylan Brooks also hit big shots.
Şengün, a career high 37. Şengün driving. Blocked, but fouled. A late whistle. If it's on Kessler, he has fouled out.
And how the Rockets win.
Misses them both, and
Gotta
the Jazz can win it. The Jazz can win it here. Clarkson into the front court. Clarkson pulls up. Clarkson short. Rebound. It's loose. Rockets win.
Oh, my goodness.